Hi my dear friends, today topic is transport request. What is meant by transport request? Transport request nothing but vehicle. So it can be move the data one server to another server. Everyone, before going to the topic, transport request is a very important. Try to understand clearly, and in case of any doubt, please comment in the comment box. I can revert back. I'm repeating once again. Transport request nothing but one vehicle. It can be move the data one server to another server. Example, development server to quality server and quality server to production server. Now my question is, which type of data can move with the help of transport request? You just try to understand this scenario. Basically, in the SAP, we have two types of screens. One is SAP Easy Access screen and one is SPRO screen. In the SAP Easy Access screen, we can post document entries, nothing but transactional data. In the transactional data, TR cannot generate it. It means transactional data cannot move with the help of TR. Transactional data cannot generated or cannot move with help of TR one server to another server. Very simple. In the transactional data, TR cannot generated. In the master data, nothing but GL creation, vendor creation, customer creation, like asset creation, all the master data. If you create any master data, TR cannot generated. It means with help of TR, master data cannot move one server to another server. Now the here very important, in the SPRO screen we have configurational data. It means whatever activity you do in the SPRO screen, that activity is called configurational data. If you do anything in the configurational data, TR can generate. Now my answer is only configurational data can move development server to quality server, quality server to production server. It means what you want to understand? If you post any document entries, TR will cannot generate it. If you create any master data, TR will not generate it. But if you do any activity in the configurational data in SPRO screen, TR can generate it. Only configurational data can move one server to another server. Example, development server to quality server to production server. So let's create one TR in the T code SC09 or SC10. Then release TR, how to create the TR and all, let's see that. Okay. Example, I want to create company code. In this company code data, I can move one server to another server. Okay. Let's go to, first you can create the TR. On the TR, you can save one company code. Then we can move or release. And what is the activities? Let's see that. Everyone. Yeah. First, what will I do? First, I can create the TR. Create TR. What is that? And SC09 or SC10. Let's go to SC09, guys. Go to SC09. And or SC10, whatever, SC09 or SC10, press enter button in the keyboard. Here we want to create the TR. Here you want to select customized request. You don't want to select workbench request. Why? Because workbench request used by the technical consultant. customized request used by the functional consultant. It means FI consultant, MM consultant, SD consultant can use for the customized request. So select your customized request and click on your create. Click on your create. Simply click on your create and select your customized request, then OK. Now simply here you can write the description. So request number here in this field, request number will generate automatically. Okay, here you can write the description, TR description. Example, company code creation means I want to create one company code. That company code I can save in this TR. In the which screen you will create the company code? In the SPRO screen. Okay, company code creation. Then click on your save. See this one? TR has been generated. Everyone. So now there is a no data. This is called main TR and this is called sub TR. Let's create one company code and let's check that. Go back. Now create the company code. Go to SPRO, enter SAP reference IMG. And select your enterprise structure. I'm repeating once again, whatever activity you do in this screen, okay, IMG screen or SPRO screen, whatever activity you do in this screen, TR can generate. Okay, whatever activity you do in SAP easy access screen, like master data creation, account document entry posting, you can do anything. TR cannot generate in the SAP easy access screen. Okay, let's go to SPRO, enter SAP reference IMG. So now I want to create company code. Select here enterprise structure and definition financial accounting and example edit copy delete check company code. You just double click on here and here and edit company code. And click on your new entry and set up here any 4-digit. Example, TI01, like example TI Steel Private Limited. Steel Private Limited. City like Prodhatur. Country India, currency INR, language English. Then press enter button in the keyboard. One pop-up will come and click on your, you just click on your save, one pop-up will come. Here you can enter your complete company code address. Example, it's an a company and like TI Steels Private Limited. And search term, enter here any 4-digit TI PL address. Example, Sriram Nagar, house number 6543 and 5000026 and Prodhatur. And country India, region 01. Then here you can add all the KYC details in case if you want to add, like telephonic number, mobile number, fax number, blah blah blah, XYZ. Then click on your OK. Now see this one. Now the TR will going to generate. OK. Okay. So is this your TR? No, this is not my TR. I want to save in my TR. Click on your own request and select here your TR. Company code creation. This is my TR. So this TR number will generated automatically. You just select this TR and click on your save. Okay. This one, data can save. Let's go back. Now let's check the TR. And release the TR. Okay, how to check the TR, how to release the TR? Again, same T code, SC09 or SC10, and click on your, select your modifiable and released. Can select your display. So what is my TR? This is my TR, company code creation. So click on your elaborate. So this is called sub TR and this is called main TR. If you create TR, sub TR and main TR updated automatically. Okay. And click on your elaborate once again. So here I created company code. That is the reason it's cascade. So this is the data can saved in this TR. Okay, what type of company code I created? Example, see this one, I created 800 client. My company code is TI01. And click on your elaborate once again. This is address, what address I maintain and all, pin code and all, everything will going to saved here. Now how to release the TR? This is our target actually. How to release the TR? Everyone concentrate here. In case if you want to release the TR directly, you don't want to release main TR directly, first you can select sub TR. Then click on your release. Click on your release. It's going on browse. See this one? It can be released. Again, now the tick mark has came. Now again select your main TR. Click on your release. This one transport. It's a vehicle. TR nothing but vehicle, can move the data one server to another server. So select your main TR, then move. It's going on browse. Wait for some time. Yeah, see this one. It says a going on browse. Now it can be, see the message. Local request, request number released. It can be released. So now what can you do? What you want to do? For example, go back. And select here only released, then press enter button in the keyboard. See this one, this is I released, tick mark. Now what can you do? Let's take this screenshot what you released. And send this screenshot to the basis consultant. So basis consultant can dump the data one server to another server. You want to put mail to basis consultant with the CC of your team lead and manager, then basis consultant can dump the data one server to another server. I am repeating once again, only configurational data can move or can generate the TR. Master data and transactional data cannot update TR or cannot generate the TR. Okay. So thanks everyone. Thanks for joining. And in case of any doubts, please drop in comment box.